Hey there, VectorShift added a bunch of really cool features lately, and I thought it would be fun to explore these by building a lead generation workflow. I created this Google Sheet that contains a list of company names, and what this workflow should do is run through each of these companies and extract certain information online. So I want to know what industry they're in, their location, and things like their email address and phone number. We could expand this to look for important persons, their roles, etc. But I think this is a good foundation. Now, this workflow actually does a whole bunch of really cool things. It can call other pipelines in a loop to extract this information and then finally update this Google Sheet. Let's have a look at this in action first. So let's run this pipeline. So the first thing it did was to retrieve the business names from the spreadsheet. It's now calling this research pipeline, which will go and perform research on our behalf. And then finally, our Google Sheet will be updated. And in the details tab, we can see the name of the company, the industry they're in, the location of their headquarters, their email addresses, and their phone numbers. This workflow uses a lot of very cool features within VectorShift, and it actually consists out of three different pipelines. So we've got this main pipeline that's responsible for reading the data from the spreadsheet, calling the research pipeline, and then finally updates our Google Sheet. And if we have a look at this lead generation pipeline, this pipeline takes in a company name as input. It then goes online and performs a Google search to retrieve certain information. It then continues to perform some deep research by scraping several URLs and extracting information from those pages. It even creates a temporary vector database to find the most relevant information from the content that was retrieved. And we also use the extract data node to retrieve very specific information from the extracted text. So let's go ahead and actually build this out from scratch. The first step is to create a Google Sheet. So just go to docs.google.com/spreadsheets and then create a sheet with two tabs. The first tab is called Companies and the second tab is called Details. In the Companies tab, create one column with the name Company and add as many businesses as you want. I'll just stick to these three businesses. Then under details, I'm just going to clear out these values and all we want are columns for the company, the industry, location, email, and the phone number. Then back in VectorShift, let's create a new pipeline. Let's create a pipeline from scratch. Let's call it lead generator. The first thing we want to do is grab the list of company names from this companies tab. So what we can do is go to integrations, and let's add the Google Sheet node. Then let's select Read from Sheet. We then have to connect our Google account. I've already connected my account, but you can simply click on this button, then click on Add Integration, select your Google account. Then on this screen, simply say Continue. Just click on Continue again, and that's it. VectorShift is now connected to your Google account. We can rename these nodes by clicking on this input, and let's call this one Read Companies. Then for the action, it needs to be set to read from sheet. Then let's click on pick file, then select your Google Sheet. And for the specific tab, select the companies tab and click on confirm selection. Great, we can have a look at the output by going to general and let's add this output node. This is just useful for debugging. And then in the output field of the output node, let's type double curly braces. Let's select the read companies node. And on this node, let's select the company output. So it's this value over here, which is a list of text values. Let's test it by clicking on run and let's click on run again. Awesome. We can see that we get the three companies coming back. And we can see this is a list because of these square brackets at the start and end of the string. Right, now, what do we actually do with these values? Well, for each of these companies, we want to go online and search for all of this information, right? So we effectively want to perform a Google search to retrieve the industry, the location, the email address, and phone number. And we want to do that for each and every one of these companies. So we want to run this logic in a loop. So we could try to do that within the same pipeline, but it will get quite messy. A better solution is to create a dedicated pipeline that will only focus on this research component, and then we'll call that pipeline in a loop from this pipeline. Let's go ahead and create our research pipeline. So let's go back to pipelines. Let's create new. Let's create a pipeline from scratch. And let's rename this to lead research, like so. And for this pipeline, we want to add an input node, and what we'll receive is the company name, like Tesla. So I'm going to rename this input node to company name, and we are expecting to receive text. Cool. So as I mentioned, we want to grab the company name and then go online and search up this information, the same way you would go online and search for this information as well. In fact, you might perform Google searches using different keywords as well, right? So to perform this search, we can go to data loaders and let's add web search. And more specifically, we'll use Google search. Now we can type in the search query. So I'm actually going to perform two different queries. The first one is just a general and broad search based on the company's name. So let's simply select the company name node and we'll select the text output, this value over here. And for the amount of results, I'll just limit this to 3 results. That should be enough. This node outputs 2 different fields, the list of URLs that it found on Google, and then the snippets from the search results. So if I had to search for Tesla, it's effectively this URL at the top, and the snippet would be this piece of text over here. Now, obviously, this text will not be enough for us to perform our research, so we will dive deeper by actually accessing that URL and then scraping all the content from the pages. So therefore, what we're really interested in is the list of URLs and not the snippets. And here we can see that these URLs is a list of values as well. So what we're interested in is the list of URLs. We want to loop through each of these URLs and then scrape the data from their pages. There is a tool that we can use to do that. So in the data loaders menu, we have this URL node. And what we can do is pass in a URL into this node, and VectorShift will go and scrape the content from that page. Now, if we try to attach the URLs from this Google search node, so let's select URLs, we will actually run into a bit of an issue. Let's try to run this. So let's enter Tesla and let's run this. This node executed, but it actually didn't bring anything back. And that's because it's expecting us to pass in a single URL, not a list of URLs. And again, this Google search node is returning a list of URLs. So what we could do is switch this node over to list mode. And now this will process each of these items one by one and then produce a final output. Let's run this again and let's go to additional outputs. And look at that. This time we did receive a response. Now, an even cleaner approach is to move this loader into its own pipeline as well. And that seems to be a common trend with building VectorShift pipelines. If you are processing data in a list, it's way cleaner sometimes to create a separate pipeline for it. So instead of adding the loader here, let's go back to our pipelines. Let's create a new pipeline. Let's create it from scratch. And let's call this read URL. This takes in an input. This input is simply a URL. And now we can go to data loaders. Let's add the URL node. Let's grab the URL from the first node, like so. And finally, let's simply output the result from this node, like so. That's all we have to do for this pipeline. And this also gives us flexibility that if we wanted to do something additional with these results, we could add additional processing within this pipeline. Let's just keep it simple. In order to use this pipeline in our other pipelines, we first have to deploy it. So I'll simply click on deploy. Cool. Let's go to our pipelines. Let's go back to our lead research pipeline. And now after the Google search node, we can go to general and add this pipeline node. This will allow us to call other pipelines within VectorShift. So in this dropdown, let's select our read URL pipeline that we just created. Then let's grab the URLs from our Google search node and let's select URLs. And of course, this is a list of URLs, so let's enable list mode. Great, let's actually run this. Let's enter Tesla and let's have a look at the output. So in this node, we can see that we get a list of responses back, and this contains all the scraped data from those web pages. I'm actually going to add another Google search node, as this node will return general information about something like Tesla. But if we want to get more specific results like contact information, we can simply perform another Google search. So let's go to data loaders. Let's add web search. Let's select Google search. And in the search query, let's grab the company name and let's select text. I'll also limit the amount of search results to 3. And I'm going to change the search query slightly to say it's going to be the company name followed by contact info. This should give me things like phone numbers and email addresses. But just as we did with the previous Google search node, we also need to scrape these URLs. So under general, let's add the pipeline node. Let's select our read URL pipeline. Let's switch this over to list mode. And of course, let's attach this. And for the URL, let's select Google Search 1 and the URLs. Awesome. So this will now search Google to get the company's contact info and will then scrape all the pages returned by this node. Now we have a lot of content about this company. Here we have a lot of general information and here we have contact information. We can now merge all of these results into one text block by going to general. Let's add this text block. And here we can see this node accepts text from upstream nodes and allows you to write additional text, concatenate different texts to pass them to downstream nodes. We want to concatenate these different results. So in its text block, let's type double curly braces. Let's grab pipeline 0.output and let's also include pipeline 1.output as well. So the results from these two nodes. Now the reality is that this text block will contain a lot of different information, right? We've scraped several pages now for general information and contact information, and we really don't want to bring everything back. We only want to retrieve things like the location, email, and phone number. So there are different ways to try and get that information. We could pass all of this text to a large language model and then ask it to find this information for us, or we can use a very cool node offered by VectorShift called the Semantic Search node. We can find that node on the knowledge base and this search node. This is really cool. It still uses a large language model under the hood, but it kind of creates a temporary vector database. So it will load in all of this text and we can then run queries against that text to retrieve any information we want from it. This is really fast and super efficient. So for the documents to search, we simply want to grab the text generated by this node. I'm just going to rename this to all information. And then in documents to search, let's grab all information. And on this, let's grab the text output. So this value over here. Now we can run any query we want against this information. For instance, let's ask, what is the email? Now let's run this. Let's enter Tesla as the company name. Let's run this pipeline. And let's have a look at this output. So we get these different chunks back, which is a list of results. And within these chunks, I can already see the email address being returned right over there. Now, we don't just want to run one query, right? We want to get other things as well, like the phone number, the industry, and the location. So we can just enhance this query a bit to ask what's the industry, what's the headquarter location, what's the email, and what's the phone number. So this node will greatly simplify the text that we need to work with. It will only return the chunks that contain this information. So now to extract only the text we want, we can use a really cool node called the extract data node. So I'm simply going to search for it. So let's search for extract. There we go. Extract data. And this is such a useful node. All you do is you pass in a piece of text. And look, if we wanted to, we could have just passed in all of this text over here. But this really is massive and not really easy to process. So the semantic search definitely narrowed down the content that we want to work with. And let's pass in all the text that we want to work with. So first, let's pass in the company name. So I'll simply select it from the company name node and the text output. Then let's pass in all this additional context. So I'll just call this context. And below it, let's grab the semantic search node and we'll pull in the chunks. Awesome. So now that we've passed in all of this text, we can now tell the extract data node exactly which fields we want to extract. So it's basically all of these fields over here. We want the industry, location, email, and the phone number. So for the first field, let's call this industry, which is of type text. And for the description, let's enter industry that company is in. Let's add another field. This one we'll call headquarter location of type text. And for the description, we'll just enter headquarter location for the company. Let's add another field. This one we'll call email. And for the description, we'll say company's best contact email. And finally, let's also add the phone number. And for the description, we'll just say company's best phone number. Cool. All that's left to do now is to output each of these fields from this pipeline so that we can use it in that main pipeline. So let's go back to general and let's start adding these output nodes. The first one we'll simply call industry. And for the output, we'll grab the extract data node. And on this node, we want the industry output. Let's simply repeat the step for each of those other outputs as well. So this one we'll call location. And for the output, let's grab the extract data node. And let's select the headquarter location output. Let's do the same thing for the email. So I'll just call this one email. And for the output, let's grab the extract data node and let's select the email. Cool. And finally, let's expand this. Let's call this one phone. And for the output, we'll select extract data and let's select the phone. So it seems we've got all of our outputs. All that we have to do now is publish this pipeline like so. And let's actually run this by itself. So we'll run it using Tesla. And in this chat window, we can actually see each of those outputs that we are exporting from the pipeline. Let's see what results we get back. Okay, so let's see what we got back. For the industry, we've got automotive. We get the location back. We've got the email as well as the phone number. Awesome. So we now have our research pipeline. Now we can go back to our main lead generator pipeline. And this is actually the easiest pipeline of them all. Now that we've got the list of companies, we can simply add this pipeline node and let's select our lead research pipeline. And for the company name, we can simply grab it from read companies and the company output. So this guy over here, because this is returning a list of values, we need to enable list mode on this pipeline. And this will then return the list of emails, industry, location, and phone numbers. And what we want to do with this output is to write it to our Google Sheet within this details tab. So let's go to integrations. Let's select Google Sheet and let's select column list writer. So this will simply take the list of items over here and write them to the columns in this Google Sheet. So simply select your Google account, click on next. Let's pick the file. So I've only got this one over here. And within this file, we want to populate the details tab. Let's confirm the selection. And now we have to map these outputs to the columns in the spreadsheet. So we can get the company name from this initial node, this Google Sheets node. So let's select read companies and let's select the company name. For the industry, we'll use this pipeline node and we'll grab the industry output. Let's do the same for the location, like so. Let's do the same thing for the email and let's do the same thing for the phone number. And believe it or not, that's actually all we have to do. Let's go ahead and test this. So let's click on run. We don't have to enter any inputs as the Google Sheet is our trigger. Let's run this. Our output node is giving us these three values. And we can see the research pipeline is currently executing. And look at that. Our workflow populated all of this information for us. This error is simply a formatting issue within Sheets. So we do get the correct number back. Google Sheets doesn't know what to do with it. So I'll simply add this little single quote and that fixes up the formatting. I hope you found this video useful. If you would like to know all the fundamentals of using VectorShift, then check out my full tutorial over here. Let me know in the comments what other projects you would like me to create using VectorShift. Remember to like this video and subscribe for more VectorShift content. I'll see you in the next one.